Here with What's Pouring at Eighth Wonder Brewery is Justin Davies. Hey, Justin, how's it going?
Hello, Derek. Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much for coming in. And you are the tap room manager.
Right. I invite everybody down to have and taste our beers and see what's happening down in the East End of downtown.
And you guys are a very, very small operation, right?
Yes. We are growing. Every year we're growing very fast. We're going into our fourth year now. We just started building everything on the East End of downtown. We're really close to the BBVA Compass Stadium. We get a lot of Dynamo fans.
I'm sure you do. You guys are also blocks away from the Minute Maid Park, the Toyota Center, BBVA Stadium, like you mentioned. And there's a look at your space. That looks kind of cool with the...
That is our new outdoor space that we just started building just to get people, you know, the weather's getting great, so people can come and enjoy that outside patio area.
And, you know, I know that was a daytime photo that we just showed you of that outdoor space, but if you notice those lights that you have strung up out there, I feel like nothing is more iconic when you're outside and there are a few strings of lights and you just have this nice mood lighting.
And every Thursday and Friday night, we're starting to have live music out there.
Oh, live music.
Yes.
That's great.
Yeah.
Very, very cool.
Local bands.
Now, today, you have brought a variety of beers for us to take a look at and try. So, what do you have first?
I got the Dome Foam. This is a little throwback to the Astrodome, whenever they used to pour the beers out there. Just light, easy.
Easy the drinking. Dome Foam.
Dome Foam.
I love that name. That is so cool.
Easy drinking.
Now, when you guys are making a beer, I understand there is a very strict protocol, right? There's a whole flavor analysis and all of that, right?
Yes.
So tell me about it.
A lot goes into producing beer. Usually, from start to finish, we're talking about 5.5 hours to brew a beer. You got to mill the grain, boil it, then you add the hops to get the flavor, and then you got to let it ferment. So we're constantly checking the beer and making sure the temperatures are right and we get that taste right and get that out to the consumer.
Now, I've seen these large beer storage containers. What if something goes wrong? I always want to know that. Like, what if you get a bad batch of beer? Because it's more than just a bad can. That would be a whole lot of spoiled beer, right?
That does happen.
Does it really?
If you have bad beer, there's no way you want the customer to taste bad beer. So we got to kind of just push
it down. Just drain the whole thing.
Just chalk it up as a loss.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. You know, I saw a little behind the scenes of a beer making process once, and we tasted the grain, we tasted the hops. Is there any special sort of ingredient? I mean, clearly, you're not going to give away all your secrets here on live television. But what is it about your beer that makes it a little different from others?
I would say the ingredients that go into it, the next one we will taste, the Rocket Fuel, a lot of people like that because it's a little different. It's got a little sweetness to it, and a lot of people really like that one.
Okay, let's go for it. Here, I'll put this Dome Foam next to that one.
This is going to be our Vietnamese coffee porter, and the reason we call that is because we use the milk sugar, some lactose, and we also use Greenway coffee beans.
Oh, you're kidding.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, guys, can we get a shot of this? Check out this brew. Honestly, this looks like a glass full of just espresso.
Yeah, it looks dark and people are thinking, oh, dark beer, no. But whenever you taste it, you're going to be, okay, super sweet.
I'm going to be what?
You're going to be pretty amazed. If you're a coffee lover, I recommend this beer for everyone.
Wow, what an unusual but kind of awesome flavor.
Yeah, it's like a morning coffee.
You know, it is a little bit, does it have chocolate in it? It tastes a little chocolatey.
It has some chocolate malt. You are correct. Way to go.
See, you know, I know my dark beer. Actually, no, I don't. I just guessed. It tastes like chocolate. Coffee, and sort of there's like a hint of a beer flavor in here, but I would
encourage
you.
But that's not the first thing you taste.
No, absolutely not. Mmm. Oh, my gosh, wow. This is like the best job ever. All right, now we have our last beer here. Which one is this?
This is going to be our IPA.
The IPA, okay.
We call it a Texas IPA. The reason we do that is because we kind of focus on the element of the malt in it.
Okay. Now, Joey from Specs was saying that IPA seems to be sort of a trendy thing now. People love their IPA. Are you guys finding that at Eighth Wonder?
Yes. Our IPA and our Brewston, our pale ale, are flying out of the tap room right now.
Oh, wow. Okay. Now, this has more of a traditional dark beer flavor.
Correct.
It's a little stronger. It's a little more robust. Wow. Okay. So, if someone doesn't love beer, you're going to hook them up, right? You're going to tell them what they can try.
Down to the tap room, we have a wheat beer that we actually mix with kombucha. So the little fermented
tea. Interesting.
And that's the way to get people to taste beer without really, you know, tasting beer.
Justin Davies, thank you so much. I'm